Okay, Mayuresh Joshi joins in with his thoughts. Mayuresh, we've dissected divis quite extensively, Cipla as well. Can't quite place a finger on why is Cadila under so much of pressure today. Any thoughts you have?
Afternoon, Neeraj. No, not really sure on why, but again, I think any news related to FDA-related issues to all the plants that are probably under the scanner, I think the stocks are taking a beating. So in that sense, again, no specific information why Cadila is tanking. But as I've mentioned time and again, I think one really needs to be extremely stock-specific when it comes to the pharma space.
What are you telling your, or what are you doing in your funds? What are you telling your clients if you have them to do when it comes to pharma? A lot of stocks are available at fairly cheap valuations.
Oh yes, they are, and again, I think the emanating concerns from the US FDA are not easing any worries in terms of the earnings estimates. To top that up, there is pricing pressure coming in from the US generic market. And third, again, I think the recovery process itself, with a lot of these FDAs playing out, the remediation issues, the cost associated with that, is clearly putting a dampener in terms of FY17 earnings. So I think one really needs to roll over onto FY18 earnings, and if one does that, I think the large cap pharma names have taken quite a hit, both in terms of the news flow coming through and both in terms of the earnings estimates getting downgraded. In that case itself, I think Lupin is something that I'll be still preferring from the large cap space. A decent enough product portfolio profile, 142 ANDAs pending, and the management is extremely focused on doing 20 to 25 launches in the coming fiscal. What this does to its margins, I think the margins should get sustained. And largely, again, even on the domestic front, if you talk about the NLEM portfolio, I think that is quite manageable in my opinion. The management also expects Gavis to probably post top line of almost $250 million, and even with one expects R&D to stay elevated to 11-13%. I still expect an earnings growth of around 17% over the next 2 years. I still expect the top line to grow by 17%, anywhere around the 18,650 odd crore mark. EPS should come anywhere around 70 odd rupees, and again I think if Lupin manages to launch the product profile that it has, I think the earning multiples can be much higher. So I think Lupin is something that I'll be extremely optimistic about. But on an equal note, I think Sun Pharma can be held on. I think all the bad news associated with that stock, in my opinion, is there in the price. Yes, Q3 numbers can be a dampener of sort. Halol probably can get delayed by a couple of quarters, 3 quarters. But again, I think we've taken conservative estimates both in terms of top line as well as the earnings growth for Sun Pharma. Again, the product profile, the kind of launches, the Ranbaxy integration, synergies coming through, and together I think they will probably account for margins probably stabilizing. Cash on books, 15,000 odd crores, also gives a decent comforting level, and the domestic formulation is on an extremely strong footing for Sun Pharma. So I think investors might get picked up with a fall in the price, but hold on, I think over the next 2 years the earnings recovery can be equally sharp in my opinion.
Okay, CK, a couple of stocks that are, by the way, something's further happened in ESAB, or are my eyes playing tricks on me? Just get in. No, nothing much. Okay, CK, a couple of stocks which are losing out. Beautiful calls there. One of them was on a Jubilant FoodWorks, which is now trading at new 52-week lows. Just want to couple that up with Delta Corp as well, which is also trading, I think, at 6-month lows or maybe 8-month lows.
Well, I think Jubilant looks weak even now, so I don't think one should really be looking at buying back or even venturing with any sort of long. So I would leave it short until the market itself were to make a bottom or it drops on further. So I think that is one stock which is weak. As far as Delta is concerned, it has got into a bit of a, let's say volatility at the current levels, and that could be because there are some set of people who are looking for value at the current, and but I think it'd be a little too premature because the first leg of the decline was so sharp, and that any kind of recovery from that would remain subnormal. But that said, the next round of decline will also remain subnormal. So even though you fell from what, 200 down to about 90, you can't really expect a repeat of some very large leg down from the recent swing high peak of 120. I think this will drift down to about 80. I think that should be around the bottom, and then it will consolidate there for a while. So I don't think Delta is going to get up in a hurry. So adventurous buying should be avoided right now.
Okay, let's get a sense of what dealers are recommending in the session today. And Yatin is here with a list of some stocks that are top of mind of dealing rooms. Yatin.
Neeraj, today is a pharma day, you know. We have two big announcements, one for Divi's Labs and one for Cipla. And if you look at Cipla, clearly the market is quite excited with the kind of approvals that they have got today. The UK MHRA has approved Seroflow, which is a complex inhaler, a generic version of Glaxo's Adavair inhaler. You know, in terms of the European exposure, Cipla was waiting to launch this particular product for last few quarters. And today the final approvals come in from the UK MHRA, which is the UK drug regulator. So a big, uptick is what we are looking at. The stock is at a 50-day moving average, and dealers are indicating that purely on the basis of F&O trends and the kind of move that we have seen today on huge volumes, is something which is looking for a BTST trade for dealers. Bharat Financial, that is one stock wherein FIs are aggressive sellers. Yesterday also we were talking about this, and today also we are looking at some good delivery based selling which is happening in Bharat Financial. Stock almost down 6.5% at the day's low. And Tata Elxsi, this is another stock wherein dealers are anticipating some selling pressures to come in. They have the stock has broken important levels, and dealers are further expecting a 3-4% trading downside from here on.
Okay, Yatin, many thanks for giving us that quick perspective on what dealers are suggesting. It's been a day dominated by pharma, and primarily Divi's Labs, Cipla, as well as Cadila Health come to mind. Two down, one up, and that's how the story is divided. 3:20, that's getting closing strategies. You go first, Siddharth.
HDFC Bank, the stock is looking good. If you look at, you know, the move, today's move, it's engulfing last five trading sessions moves. Trying to move about 200 DMA, seeing built up of positions, cash was buying visible on screen. I'm anticipating that it's moving towards probably 1220 odd levels, where it would face resistance in form of 89 EMA. So trade with positive bias in HDFC Bank.
Kunal, what about you?
Tanvir, I would want to reiterate Bosch. I think the stock is looking extremely good. I've been doing this for the last one day. Morning also I recommended the stock. I think it's just about closing at the high point of the day. Traders could look at a target of 20,700. So more of a reiteration of what I gave in the morning as well. Stop loss remains the same, 18,700.
Nice one, Kunal. Really good call on an intraday basis. I think it's gone up. So good going there. Today the opening calls have all worked beautifully from our experts. CK, what's the closing call though? Your closing call.
Well, I think Cipla has been under discussion, and the way it has moved, this big long range bar that we have seen is definitely launching an upside. So I would say BTST on Cipla at the current price of 582, even though it's up 3.5%, I think this is just the thing. We should see something like 620, 625 from a trading perspective at least by tomorrow.
By the way, Emami has had an interesting move in the last 15 minutes of trade. I must add that Divi's Lab 2 is recovering a little bit. Okay, this is Divi's Lab, and official comments coming in, say 18R exclusive. 18R has accessed the form 483 of Divi's Lab, and let's get those comments. Maybe Darshan will come in again, but observations confirms data falsification by company. This is now ETNow giving you exclusive information. We had MK giving out the note, but this is the form 483 is there with ETNow, and we learning that there is an observation 5 which confirms data falsification by the company. So, you know, we'll wait for the company to come and clarify, but the FDA report clearly stating that it was data falsification. This is not good news. There might be a short-term uptick right now in Divi's because a lot of intraday traders who've gotten that 10-15% as the case may be, might be squaring off their positions, taking the money home, going for the weekend, Christmas weekend. But suffice to say, this is not good news for Divi's Lab. Probability could be, you know, looking at maybe some more downside as well. I think that's what the analysts are best saying as well.
I just very quickly want to get Siddharth's perspective on Divi's Labs, given what the internal positions are looking like. Like Neeraj said, you know, we've seen a 26% down, almost like a severe cut in the stock. Can't say crash, but a very, very severe fall. And from there, a bit of a bounce back.
So, you know, open interest has already more than doubled in today's trading session, more than 100% rise in open interest. But when, you know, such news happen and when such kind of price action take place, I don't think so positions or technical levels has any significance. It's more, the stock would react more to, you know, further news flows, management commentary and how the funds would move in and out of this stock. You guys were discussing about a lot of mutual funds holding this kind of stock. So I think we should not, you know, dwell too much into the levels and positions in such kind of cases.
Okay. I think Dr. Narayan, did we take your strategy as well? It just missed my mind.
Hello.
Okay.
Yeah, I did give you. I did give you a buy in Cipla.
Sorry about that. Yeah. So let's start just you know, looking at the top pharma stories, because the last 16 minutes have really been about pharma. You have Divi's Labs on your screen. Cadila Health comes in next, where there is pressure, and the stock is down about 7%. Dr. Narayan spoke about Cipla and the upside to this one. Really derives value from the fact that 625 was in fact Dr. Narayan's target. It derives value from the fact that this drug clearance in from the UK regulator for the US UK markets could be game changing as far as their respiratory portfolio goes. They have already launched in 7 other countries, and the size of the UK market is about 400 million for Seriflow. So the generic version of GSK's Advair, a drug treating asthma, may really add a lot of weight on the profitability of Cipla if they are able to capture a chunk of that $400 million market in the United Kingdom. That's the third stock.
Yeah. Quick calls though on Maruti and Bajaj Auto. Kunal Bothra, any thoughts here?
Yeah, I think on Maruti, you know, Neeraj, I think this is a good move because I think it's coming out of a consolidation. The volumes today are at a 5-day high, so maybe a weekly high in terms of, you know, volumes. Maybe I would wait for a confirmation, you know, on Monday if the stock opens, you know, gap up. I would not want to hurry. I would, you know, look out to buy Maruti as well. Bajaj Auto, I haven't, you know, seen the chart as such. But I think looking at the immediate chart patterns, today's move still below the 20 moving average. There are a lot of stocks which are actually forming double bottoms. You know, Nifty also, I think 7930, and now we are at 7980-85 odd. We've hit that at 7950 odd levels on spot level. So a lot of stocks which are hitting double bottom. So we need to see how, you know, many of these individual stocks, especially the large cap funds, perform over the next couple of days, because probably that could also give a sense on the indices.
Okay. CK, any sugar name up your radar? CK Narayan?
Sugar, you asked?
Yes, CK.
Well, one of the sugar stocks that I always like is the Dwarike Sugar. The other one is EID Parry. I think both of them were in action today, and even at the current levels, they merit attention for near-term buys. I think sugar cycle is up again, and both Dwarikesh has a very high beta, whereas EID Parry has got very high pedigree, and I think is more institution patronage. So one from each side, I think both of them will do very well.
So that, just very quickly, Bajaj Finance, Bajaj Finserv. Quick thoughts here, please.
So Bajaj Finance, I track closely. Superb, you know, bounce back from lower levels. I think one should not be short in this counter right now, because today's volume is much higher than, you know, past 7-8 trading sessions volumes. And again, this today's candle has been suggesting that, you know, past 3 days price movements have been covered on the upside. It is possible that, you know, stock can move towards 860, 870. But if you are thinking of trend in change and again a reversal and uptrend to start, till the time stock doesn't close above 865, 870, you should not think about that. So play for a bounce back, but reversal, one has to wait.
Bounce back and for reversal, wait on. That's Siddharth's perspective on Bajaj Finance. I think the 7-day chart, and before we start wrapping up, the market would reflect that, because Bajaj Finance has been just getting adjusted lower. This is one of the few days where that traction has come back. There you go. Classically explains what's happening technically on the stock. We'll start wrapping up the market. 79.90 coming in on the index, with the broader markets trading with a bit of a negative bias. We're looking at Cipla, top gainer. No prizes for guessing why. As 3.5% higher, Bajaj Auto gives it company, so does Bosch, Maruti Suzuki is doing well, Sun Pharma, L&T, Gale, top gainers here. Motor Corp, Grasim, Bharti Airtel, HDFC Bank are all top gainers in the session. Among losers, you have NHCL Tech, Axis Bank, Eicher Motors, Aurobindo, which are trailing weaker. Tech Mahindra, Bank of Baroda, Hindalco, all of them closing with about a percent and a half, 2% cut. But there are no exaggerated gains or cuts in the market. It's split down the middle, and the index also has closed below 8,000. But aside of that, there's been a lot of intraday volatility. What one needs to take away from the market today is the fact, as we close out the session in the week, that we've lost about 2.5% on the benchmark indices in the last seven sessions, including the 2 days of trade last week. And for the mid-cap and the small-cap indices, close to 4.5% over the last 7 trading days.
And then the others, Tanveer, Bajaj Finance, for example, let me start off with that. The divisa, of course, remains the topmost draw. But Bajaj Finance, good move, 6.5% up. FinServ 2 would be up. Divi's Lab 20% down. Cadila 5% down. Not good going for those. Bajaj FinServ and Bajaj and Piramal Enterprises. Again, two NBFCs, quality names. Bajaj FinServ would naturally have gone up. I don't know if Piramal has gone up or not. But no, not quite. But off the lows of the day, if that, I think, helps. There is weakness in Jubilant FoodWorks, weakness in Delta Corp. I wonder what Just Dial is up to. Should come up on your screen as well. Hitting new lows along with Jubilant every single day. No, but Just Dial down percent. Jubilant FoodWorks and Delta Corp, amongst other concept stocks that are facing sweet chin music. What else? Max Ventures is doing well. Raj Industries up about 4.5%. Dredging Corporation about 4%. Chola Investment 3.5% at 932. Emami, as I said, has inched up a bit as well. And then a clutch of mid caps and small caps. But it's a afternoon that's belonged to Divi's Labs. It's cracked. When the news came, it was down 3.5%. When the news broke on ET Now, and then it's gone down all the way to 25%. Maybe short term. Intraday short covering has brought it up a bit, but should be interesting to see what it does starting Monday. So that's the long and short of what's happened in the markets, really. Just before we make you see the ET Now Christmas quiz, I think we need to take a final comment from Mayuresh Joshi and then let me go. Mayuresh, we've discussed pharma at length. Maybe talk about some of the NBFC bets and what are you doing there, maybe a Bajaj Finance, for example.
No, again, largely Neeraj. I think one really should expect a weak set of numbers to come through, and as the management and the con call indicated, you are seeing softness in sales coming through. So in that sense itself, I think the quantum of degrowth, both in volume and value terms, is something that can be gauged only after the Q3 results. So I think one really needs to wait for those results to come through. But largely, again, I think I will be selective when it comes to the whole space. I think within the NBFC's housing finance, retail-oriented ones is something that I'll still continue to like, post numbers coming through being the caveat. But even within the banks, I think Federal Bank is something that I'll still be pushing. That stock corrects anywhere between 5 and 10%. The exposure to wholesale corporate borrowing has come down significantly to 34%. The SME part in terms of advances has gone up to 34%. But again, I think with demonetization and the expected stress coming on that side of the book, one might expect some amount of increase in provisionings taking place. But the slippages reported in Q2 at 266 crores along with the restructured book, so if you account for both of them at 1.2% and 3.6%, at 4.8%, the total stressed book appears far better than what it was a couple of quarters back. Credit costs are expected to come down from 120 pips to around 80 to 90 pips over the next 2 years, which will lead to an improvement in ROAs to around 0.9 from 0.5. ROAs to improve significantly from the current levels as well. And even at the current juncture, my own sense is that the risk reward is in favor of Federal Bank, so it trades around 1.3 times price to adjusted book. So any correction to that tune, I think, offers good opportunity to long-term investors.
Thanks, Mayuresh. Happy holidays to you. Merry Christmas to you and Team Angel from all of us out here at ET Now. Kunal Bothra, quick perspective from you. How are you approaching trade?